That's my bloody nose. Yeah, my bloody nose at home. this is every Saturday.
I don't have anything to do.
I have like air.
Oh, I gotta get a camera.
I mean, maybe if your back slams into my face, it has
oh, man.
Let's see it.
Oh my goodness.
Oh wow.
Can you feel that?
I had to clean your
tips. What?
Josh, how do you do this to us? We trust you to drive us.
We kind of forced him to drive us.
Yeah, we did force him.
We didn't really force him. Josh, I didn't want to. But then you thought about it and you made the right decision.
Sydney, how could you do this to me?
I'm sorry.
Honestly, I blame
Kate.
Muddy.
That's it.
What
could
possibly go wrong?
Yeah, Nina, what could possibly go wrong?
Okay, I wanted to be a part of it because I had an experience with it when I was driving and someone else got into an accident and I was the one that had to call 911. So it was very traumatizing for me. So I wanted to make sure that it doesn't happen again at our school.
Why did you want to be a member of the Air?
So I'm on the Municipal Alliance in town, and I'm in charge of spreading their message through like outreach and communication, which is promoting a drug-free and drug and alcohol-free environment. So I think it's really important to do this. And I know it's like easier. It's easy to say like you'll never drive drunk, but a lot of people do. Like there's a reason it's still happening. So I think it's really important to do this and do it in front of my peers, spread the message.
Fellas, great job.
Thank you. I'm sorry, can I get a high five?
Of course.
I don't want a high five played out on hold.
You got involved because?
My friend Tracy Becker brought the programs to Providence, and we're good friends, and she knew I was a filmmaker, and she asked me to get involved, and I wasn't particularly psyched about it until we did it, and then I realized how awesome the program was, and I'll do them forever, as long as they let me do them, I'll do them.
Nice.
So we just finished filming scene one with the lovely young ladies in car one, and they were talking about the nasty taste of whatever was left in these cans. Now, how did this taste? I know you guys were pretending, but you tasted something, right?
Yeah,
it was like in
old water.
Water.
No, it's old water.
I think no, it tasted like metal.
Metal.
It was like gross. Flat.
It was gross.
It was like
sewer water.
It's still in my mouth.
It was sewer water.
No, really.
She literally needs to drink something to get rid of the sewer water taste. Not alcohol, but maybe Kool-Aid or Gatorade or something.
I think it was like whatever was in there was sitting there for a while. Yeah. Just started.
Yeah.
Mm.
To marinate and make it so
that's good. That's dedication to acting marinate. Right there. Because they stayed in character even though she was sipping metal. End scene. Thank you, ladies.
You guys carry these. So today's every 15 minutes. Why is this program so important to New Providence?
Well, this is actually our 10th year, so we do it every 2 years, for our fifth time doing it. And the importance in the program is that it really does bring awareness to our students in a way that becomes very real for them. So through many of the programs that we've done since students have been in kindergarten, we've been speaking about the dangers of drinking and driving. But what this program does specifically for the high school age students is that it actually puts it into very real and realistic terms for them. So simply just before, when I walked into one of the classrooms and we announced that one of the students was in a drinking and driving accident, you could just feel in the room the emotion that the students are experiencing in that moment. Likewise, later on today, when we then actually do the whole entire scene, again, you can just feel in that moment the emotion that the students are experiencing through that simulation. I do believe that it does have an impact for them. And I do believe that over the years, the feedback that we've received from them as well as from their parents has been one that has been positive in the sense that it has allowed them to reflect as they go into the end of the school year and into prom and prom weekend and graduation, and just making the right decisions. And not only for themselves, but when they see a friend that may potentially be looking to make a wrong decision, they step in. And I think that's most important, and that's why we continue to bring it back.
So I just want to say, 5 years now, we've done the every 15-minute program. I was actually one of the original officers. I'm handing the torch off to Officer Carlino now, but the same message applies. We're doing this to get the message to the kids, to make sure that they're safe during their prom weekend. I know a lot of you are maybe going to the Jersey Shore, maybe out to the Poconos, renting houses, gonna have all sorts of fun and activities going on. Some of you may choose to drink, and if you do, you wanna stay away from cars, all right? You don't wanna get behind the wheel. We wanna make sure that you're safe, okay? So go out there, have a great time, but make good choices.
All right. And action.
Yo. Thank you, Christian. We appreciate it. We appreciate the ride.
This
Thank
is insane, you. Christian.
No problem.
You see, I know. I knew for a fact, you know? Like, we give you some time, a little time, walking with nature. You make the right decision.
Yeah.
We go to Top Golf, right, boys?
I hope so.
I'm down. Yeah.
Oh, Christian, down. Watch out!
Ah!
That's really bad.
No,
you seem really happy about that. You're like, watch it. Like,
oh, you're a watch out. Yeah, you're a watch out song.
Okay, you know what, Dan? Want to be in the middle?
Yeah, I could give the watch out though.
Now you're playing dual role because you're on chair. You're chair,
correct.
And then you're also a parent, mm-hmm. With someone participating. So as the parent on the parental side, how do you feel about the program and how has it impacted you as well?
Well, it's definitely a tough program as a parent. I can tear up right now, kind of watching it and just even starting to even glimpse of imagining what it would be like to be in those shoes as a parent whose child is involved in a drunk driving, and in this case, Caitlin actually dies. So it, you know, really pulled at my heart, but also made it, you know, even more important to try to keep our kids safe and make sure that they really realize the consequences of their actions and to help them make really, really good choices for themselves and others.
What are you doing next year?
I'm going to UCLA. I'm going to study computational biology with a minor in entrepreneurship, and I'm super excited.
Woohoo!
Thank you.
What are you doing Karina. Next?
We're driving to Caitlin's house.
In real life.
I'm going to Bard College
okay.
in the fall.
What are you going to study?
I don't know what I'm going to study yet. It's undecided.
What is your plans for the future after high school?
I'm going to go to college, hopefully graduate, and then get a good job and make some money.
Nice. Plan. Okay. What are your plans for the future after high school?
I would like to go to college, and I would eventually like to get into a medical school. It was very hard to get into though, so I think I'll do my best to see whatever mm-hmm. happens. But most importantly, I want to have a family. Like,
okay.
Like, no med school is okay, but I definitely want a family.
Definitely want a family.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. And what are your plans for the future after high school?
So I want to go to college, and then after college, hopefully serve in the military and see what happens after that.
Plans for the future. Well, definitely want to go to college. I'm only a junior right now, so I don't have, you know, a university or a major like set in stone. But definitely go to college and then, you know, see where it takes me from there.
Okay. And thus far, what's one of your favorite high school memories?
Probably recently, this past weekend, we won our sectional championships for track and field.
Nice. And what do you run?
I run the mid-distance, so anywhere from the 800 to like 2 miles.
Nice. What are your plans for the future after high school?
I'm attending West Virginia in the fall, and I'm going to be studying criminal justice there, hopefully graduating, have a good time out there, and then work towards my career becoming a police officer.
Nice, nice. And what's one of your favorite high school memories?
My favorite high school memory by far was making it down to state to wrestling, because it just showed my dedication to like the sport, and like meant a lot to me, because like I worked
pretty much my whole life to achieve that goal.
So you've been wrestling for how long, would you say?
Since fourth grade.
Wow. Awesome. Okay, great. Thank you. And what was one of your favorite high school memories?
Winning group championship for basketball this year.
What position?
I didn't really play too much, but...
But still, what position did you like to play? Or would you play?
Shooting guard.
Okay, yeah. You got a little bit of a jump shot.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. And what was one of your favorite high school memories?
My favorite high school memory was when one day Gary from cafeteria, he made this panini. It was the first time he made it. Mm. It had a burger patty in it, as well as bacon and cheese. So it was like a bacon cheeseburger panini. I was mind blown that day. I had two.
Thank you.
Don't get that in.
Okay. Your eyes are so happy, though.
So, now that you've gone through the accident for every 15 minutes and you have glass in your head and you were through the windshield, How do you feel about the experience of it all?
Honestly, it was way more intense than I was anticipating, because I kind of was expecting something, but then like once it was all happening and you could hear all the police and stuff, it was really intense and really scary. It was very scary. It felt super real, but it wasn't, thank goodness. But
right.
It felt super, super real. And it was like, thank goodness it's not real, because I couldn't even imagine it then.
Right. Your makeup looks very, very real. I just...
Why have you continued to do this?
Because I love the program, I love the message it gets, and the kids have a good time, believe it or not, doing this program, and I love working with the kids.
Awesome.
You're not acting, you're just talking.
Casual.
Be casual. Oh, that's casual.
Casual.
Are you recording?
A little bit.
Just a little bit.
Am I good? Okay. Mm.
Yeah. So, now that you've gone through the accident of every 15 minutes, how do you feel about the experience of the accident? And acting it out.
I'm pretty confident we did a good job.
Yes, you did.
I'm pretty confident we did good. It was kind of emotional. The screaming and stuff, just seeing, seeing, them drag, Caitlin out and, emotional. I started crying. I was like, I've only really been close with these people for 2 hours.
Right.
And singing in the car. And then here I am, seeing them die, crying.
It's emotional. Please don't cry now, because if you cry, I'm going to cry.
No, I'm not going to cry.
Okay, good. Because I don't want to cry in front of everybody.
I don't want to mess up the butt anymore.
And you did a very good job. You guys were all great doing the acting and getting into the scene. I even saw your hand shaking.
Yeah, no,
that was real. That wasn't acting.
That was real.
Wow.
That was real.
Wow. Well, thank you very much. We really appreciate your good, positive energy.
Yeah, thanks.
Yeah,
it's all very.
I just like to say, this group, seriously, was one of the best groups, the way you each responded that I've seen in years. I mean, seriously, really into it. Took it to heart, and it made it, that much better.
And
good job.
And he's been doing this for 15 years, he's seen a lot of them. Well, they both have.
Well, thanks for the makeup.
She's like, she was concerned about cookies. That's why she didn't hear us.
I didn't.
I'm just like that. Now, Marsha, how many years have you been doing this?
Okay.
Several?
14,
14.
Wow, 14 yeah. years. Wow. And what do you really enjoy about this experience?
The people.
The people are great. The kids are great.
Mm-hmm.
Just, and it's a relaxing atmosphere.
Mm-hmm.
Very relaxing. Like, and you don't have to rush and get stuff and get mad because they don't have what you want.
Right, right. Know. That's helpful. What do you enjoy about this process of being involved in the Every 15 Minutes program?
Probably the fact that hopefully at least one life. Yeah. I've been a paramedic for 43 years, so I've seen a lot.
Bad
things happen. And this is just a great program. To be part of it is super.
How do you feel the program has impacted you or made an impact on the students?
I think it's had a tremendous impact every year on the students as well as the families and staff. I think it's very telling when we are in the auditorium the next day for the assembly and you hear the testimonials from our students and you see parents with tears in their eyes and you see students with tears in their eyes and our staff, including myself, typically never a dry eye in the auditorium during that entire presentation. You just feel the emotion. And so we hope as a district that that emotion carries over into the prom season and makes students think differently when they're about to get in that vehicle.
Joe Narciso does a wonderful job. My people do a wonderful job, as well as the fire department, rescue squad, EMS, everybody lends a hand. Municipal Alliance puts this together in conjunction with everyone. Joe's been doing it for years. It's a great program. It's taken very seriously and very effective, I believe, because it's deep and it hits home.
I think this is the one program we do that is the most impactful to the students. And I have had three kids go through the program, and this is before prom weekend. They all went down for prom weekend, and I was able to talk to them and their friends. And they told me very honestly that it did have an impact. It made them think twice. There were actually conversations at prom weekend about, we just saw Every 15 Minutes, do you think you really should be driving? And people even took keys away from other kids who weren't so careful and were going to drive.
So why do you feel like the Every 15 Minutes program is important?
Well, if I'm being honest, it's a very difficult program to do. So it's always, it's very headachy for me, and it's a lot of turning wheels and a lot of effort. It's also a very heavy, like emotionally heavy program. And so I'm not like a huge fan of it in that sense, if that makes sense. But the kids always like respond to it so favorably. Mm-hmm. And the parents too, like the parents of the kids that are involved, they always respond very favorably to it. And so it seems like after I do it every time, like all the headache, and then when it's done, it always seems really worth it because the kids are like, hey, you know, thanks for letting me be a part of that. And I'm like,
yeah,
okay, that's
so you feel like it's made an impact?
I do, and I, it's harder to speak to the whole, like all the 11th, 12th grade students that witnessed the program. Like I think it has that impact, but just in the five times that we've done it, where I've seen the impact the most is with the 25 or so kids that we have involved in the program. They always respond very favorably to it and just say a lot of positive stuff about being part of it. And their parents as well. Their parents always end up thanking me for like letting their kid be part of this program where they pretend to have this horrible accident. I'm like, you're welcome.
Don't stop walking.
Is this gonna be behind us?
Yes.
Oh, what's up, yo? We out here. We grinding.